All right. Now, in this video, I'm going to show you again how to put a monitoring observation into Skynet. We went through this in great detail back in Lesson 3 when we monitored moons going around a planet. So if you want all the details, go watch that video. This is just going to be a short version. Here in Lesson 5, we're instead going to monitor a variable star and a globular cluster. So let me share my screen. Okay, here we are at Skynet, and I described this in the lab. You know, this is an observation that's going to take a lot of data, 50, 80-second exposures, and that's too much for each and every student to do. It would kind of overwhelm the system. So instead, we're going to have one person per class, probably the instructor, put this observation in for the class, and then share it in the group folder with everyone. Okay, so you go to my observatory, optical observing, add a new observation. There we go. And in the lab manual, we offer three potential targets. There's one globular cluster that's a good target in the Northern Hemisphere fall semester. There's a different one that's a good target in the Northern Hemisphere spring semester. And there's another that's a good target in the Northern Hemisphere summer semester. Now, I'm recording this video in summer, so I'll just demonstrate it with the summer target, which is M28, Messier Object 28. So I'm searching. Okay, found it. I'm going to check my three numbers and set them to the defaults that we want in this lab, course, minus 12, 20, 0.5. We don't need the advanced settings. And just double check that it is observable from many different sites. And it is, so that's good. Save and choose filters. Now with this particular observation, we're going to be shooting in the V band, that's the middle of the visible band. And you can see it rules out the telescopes that do not have that filter, but we still have plenty of telescopes with that filter. I'm going to save and continue. And I could select all telescopes, but these are Southern Hemisphere targets. So the lab suggests that you select Southern Hemisphere prompt telescopes. And so we have telescopes in Chile. Slide down here. We have the prompt Meckering site in Western Australia, and it's not connected yet, but soon we'll have the prompt Siding Spring site in Eastern Australia, and you'll want to select that as well. Okay, I'm going to save and continue. I'm going to choose my design telescope, either prompt 5 or the generic, and I want 1 80-second exposure. Again, you can see on different telescopes that 80-second exposure will take different amounts of time to achieve the same signal to noise. I'm going to pick a time account that has enough credits to cover this observation. And then down under advanced settings, we're going to repeat this observation 50 times with at least 1 hour between each. We're going to make sure continue on next available telescope if interrupted is selected. That way, if a telescope goes down, we'll swap you out to another telescope. I'm just checking the cancel time. It's set for a month in the future. That's the default, and that's fine. This observation should be done by then. I'm going to save and continue. And submit. Okay, it's active. And just whoever puts it in, probably your instructor, should check back periodically and make sure that data is coming in. Okay, that's it for this video.